Hey, man, what do you want?
What do you got? Huh?
Thank you.
It's early. Please let me go back to sleep.
Oh, honey. Barry, please.
What?
All over again.
Let's go, Maria.
But how are you going to take care of yourselves?
We'll be just fine, just like we were before we could afford you. Now let's go.
But the two of you alone in this big house, you should have kept Hector.
It's time to go home, Maria. Let's go.
Si, senor, but for your protection, you know there have been a lot
Maria,
of...
Maria, out! Out!
Hi. Oh, are you going to be all right?
We'll be just fine. Oh, this is for Jimmy. How's he doing?
Oh, thank you, Mrs. Evans. He's getting better.
Great. Now have a nice weekend, Sornado. Adios. Goodbye.
Call me if you need anything, and I'll be right up.
I promise I will. And you have a wonderful weekend.
Muchas gracias. Ay, Dios, está bien, está bien.
You don't have to be so hard on her. Stop it.
You're very beautiful.
What's this?
Just something to show that I care.
Oh, that's me. It's very nice, Perry.
You like it?
Hello. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Barry.
This.
Barry, look, I just need a couple of minutes, okay?
What?
I have a few last-minute phone calls to make. It won't take long.
You promised me there would be no more business this weekend.
But it's never the weekend in Japan.
Yeah! What's in that purse? You find anything in the purse?
I don't know.
Hey, money? Oh, man. That was so much fun. You see how scared that girl was?
Yeah.
What the fuck are you looking at, huh? Show him something. Give me something to look at. Hey, wanna hit a beer?
Woo-hoo!
I mean, even if you want to message her today, I can look at it before Monday. Yeah, I've got that in front of me now. It's coming to you. Have a look at line 25 and let me know what you think. This could be altered. Right. Okay. By the 25th, I can get it to you by the 9th. Yeah. Okay. Get it to send it over this weekend. I can look at it before Monday. We'll get a head start. Okay. Exactly. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Fine. Okay, it's coming to you now. Right. Yeah, I'm gonna get a head start. Okay, let me ask you this. You are such an asshole sometimes. You just cost me 25 grand.
I'm an asshole? I was under the impression that you and I would be concentrating on each other this weekend.
As soon as I'm finished this deal.
You're already a fucking millionaire, Lydia. You don't need any more deals.
Well, I'm not going to stay a fucking millionaire if I neglect my business, am I?
No. No more deals.
Barry?
I am not listening.
Barry, come on. Barry, what do you think you're doing? Barry!
Oh, by the way, I hid the keys too.
This is really starting to tick me off, Barry. You know, this is very silly, not to mention expensive.
Bitch.
God damn it, Barry. This is so childish.
Just unplug them, and you would plug them back in, no? It's the only way I know of to keep you totally to myself during the weekend.
Okay, I apologize. I broke our agreement, and I'm sorry.
That's better.
What are you doing?
Getting out of the bed.
Oh. What are you doing?
I'm gonna tie you up.
Oh, Barry, no. You know that's no good. It doesn't work. Barry, please, listen to me.
Keep talking, baby, not like that.
All right. Barry, I'm not kidding.
Neither am I.
This is not funny. No way. Barry, come on. Stop. Barry, please, come on. It didn't work last time. It's not gonna work now. This is not funny, Barry. God. Get off. Barry, don't. Stop. I mean it now. Barry, come on. Stop it. Fingers are numb, please.
Yeah, but you look sexy.
Oh, God.
Attention. I'm gonna make you more responsive. bouncing in every sensation.
Oh, don't you think there's enough tension in our marriage already?
I'm talking about this is different. I'm talking about sexual tension. Just forget about everything and think about me, us, and just enjoy it.
Please, Barry.
You said you trusted me, honey.
Of course I trust you. You're my husband. Barry. What are you doing? Stop it! Please, Barry, please, don't. This isn't funny. Oh, Barry. Come on, please.
Where's the camera?
Barry, no way.
Barry, come back here. Untie me, goddammit. You get back here and untie me now! Shit! Fuck you, Barry!
Say cheese, baby.
No, Barry, no! You can't make me enjoy this! When are you gonna understand that?
No matter what I do, everything is too kinky for you.
Well, why don't you try something romantic?
Oh, that's beautiful. Here, you can have your own fucking way. There. You happy now?
Where are they?
What?
The pictures you took, where are they?
Oh, for Christ's sakes, Lydia. The one in the film and the fucking camera.
I got scared.
I was just playing. If this had had anything to do with your work, you would have been begging for it.
Barry, that's not true.
Liked it. Just a little. But you can't admit it, not even to yourself.
So what'd you get?
I couldn't find Chinese.
So what'd you get?
Burgers and fries.
Oh, burgers and fries.
Yeah, burgers and fries.
Oh, how romantic. What'd you do with the change? Pay off your bookie?
Oh, you're funny.
You're all class, Cal.
Yeah, well, you're all ass, Gwen.
Fuck you.
No, fuck you.
No, fuck
no,
you!
Fuck you!
And look.
Yeah.
Makes real.
She wouldn't want.
It makes me want to come.
Keep your mouth shut.
I thought you liked it better with my mouth open.
Patient. It's a big house. This up. Gwen.
Thank you.
sees us.
What can I do for you?
Is she okay?
Yeah, she's fine. What do you want?
That was totally uncalled for.
I was just playing.
Well, don't play so rough.
All right.
We're sorry to bother you folks, but...
We were driving up the coast for the weekend, and we had a little car trouble.
Well, actually, a lot of car trouble. It broke just down the road here.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that, but our phones, they don't work.
Yeah, he cut all the cords. Cal just usually throws them out the window. Phi Beta Phi? For life. Where'd you go? Long Beach State. Oh, San Francisco State.
Ah. Don't we know each other?
I don't know. I was thinking the same thing.
Are you okay?
Is she okay?
She hasn't been feeling well. You all right?
Well, look, she can rest here if she wants. Is that all right, Lydia?
Yeah, it's fine. Although I wish I could call the doctor.
We don't want to put your folks out or anything.
No, not at all.
No, look, I'll show you inside. Come on.
Thanks a lot. Really appreciate that.
Well, I hope she's going to be all right. Well,
I'm sure she will after a little rest.
I hate the thought of having strangers in our house.
If you don't like it, I'll tell them to take a hike.
Well, I can't really do that. I mean, she didn't seem well.
Lydia, it's your call.
And what about our quiet weekend together?
You're not going to be here that long.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Sit up. Yeah, sit up. Come on.
What for?
Shut the fuck up, would you? Stand up.
What for?
Stand up. Take off your dress. Take it off. Now your stockings.
Come in.
I thought you might need these.
Thanks.
What took you so long?
We made some new friends.
Oh. I bet you did.
That was interesting. What's his problem?
I don't know.
So how are you feeling?
I got the chlorine out of my lungs, if that's what you mean. So did you finally figure out where you knew him from?
Yeah, I know him from the track.
What, you guys bet at the same window or something?
No. No, I saw him working with the trainers. Actually, he knows his stuff pretty well.
What about her?
Yeah. Yeah, I seen her at the track, too. At least we know they're not total strangers.
But it's still a very awkward situation.
What do you want me to do?
I don't know. I guess we should let them stay.
That's my girl.
I think she's pretty.
Ah.
You think she's pretty?
Let go. No, I'll tell you.
You have to start off slowly. Be patient.
Patience is not one of my better qualities.
Patience is a virtue.
You have to show her the way. Don't force it. Then let her discover that it's the best way.
The best?
She can't be run full out right from the start. She has to be seduced into showing her full potential. I worked with her for months, slowly wearing down her reserve, her inhibitions.
I don't know if I could have nursed it. I probably would have pushed it too hard and hurt her.
Mm-hmm. Horses are pretty hard to hurt. Oh, oh. There, let me get that.
A toast to unbridled passion.
Cheers.
I've never met two more uncouth people in my whole life.
Just because they displayed a little bit of affection.
A little affection is one thing. Licking each other in public is something else entirely.
Hey, look, don't be so uptight.
I suppose it turned you on.
It turned you on. You just don't want to admit it.
Larry.
Lydia.
So sexy they can't contain themselves.
The question is, can we? Huh? Huh?
it. Say it.
Okay.
Yeah, okay, watch.
I'm watching them.
Yes.
Ta-dum!
What's this?
Surprise.
It's beautiful.
You're the new owner of Second Chance.
What?
I thought you could turn your racing hobby into a business.
No, really? I can't believe you did this. Thank you.
Look, you wanted a new beginning, and this is my contribution.
Sorry to interrupt. We wondered if we could use the jacuzzi.
Sure. No problem.
Hey, I think I know that horse. Won the Belmont, right?
That's right. And thanks to my lovely wife, you're looking at the new owner.
Congratulations. She's magnificent.
Yes, yes, she is.
Come on.
We'll be at the jacuzzi.
Well, she looks fine now. When are they leaving?
Did you know that Cal has trained some of the finest horses in racing? I was thinking perhaps maybe I should hire him as a consultant.
So much for no business.
Well, maybe we should keep him around just to keep you horny.
That will never happen.
Hey, but your body has a different opinion.
No.
You may say no, but you mean yes.
Barry.
Hey, let's go swimming. Now.
Yeah.
Oops. Gwen's strap broke. Damn.
That's okay. I'm used to swimming topless. If you don't mind.
It's okay with me.
Okay with you, Lydia.
No. No, I'm not comfortable with that. Here, use this.
Gwen, mind if I join you?
Go on in. Water's sweet.
What is this?
It's a small software company, right up your alley.
I hate software. You know I got killed in that business, Lydia.
Barry.
You just gave me a racehorse. That is my new business. I can stand on my own 2 feet, Lydia. I don't need some mommy prodding me in the right direction.
Then do something, Barry. Even if it's wrong, do something.
You want to know something? You were right. You know how many fucking women would like to be with me?
My anger, like my therapist told me.
You just caused an embarrassing scene in front of Gwen and Cal.
Embarrassing? Gwen and Cal don't know the meaning of the word embarrassing.
All right. I'm out of line.
This whole weekend's out of line, Barry.
Look, I know it's not what you planned.
What am I supposed to do? You invite 2 fucking sex maniacs into our home.
Excuse me, if I remember correctly, that decision was left up to you.
Well, then I made a mistake.
No, you didn't. Look, Cal may end up being an asset to me now that I'm back in racing.
Then I made 2 mistakes.
No, you didn't.
Barry, look, I just thought we were going to have a nice, quiet weekend together.
We will. We'll have our time together. I'll even make you lunch.
Okay.
Nope. Sounds like they made up.
Damn. I was hoping it would get really interesting.
If we could make it interesting.
What'd you have in mind?
What if we tied them up and had our way with them?
And lose $10,000? I don't think so.
Well, you're the one who's always bored.
Lord, not stupid. I'm gonna go look around.
Don't get into any trouble.
Who, me?
Lunch is almost ready. I thought you forgave me.
On one condition.
All right.
Can we make an appointment to see my therapist next week? Together.
Okay, next week. It's lovely.
You like it?
Mm. Oh, yeah. Did you miss that? Mm-hmm. Ah, damn it! What did you do that for?
See if you're mad enough for me.
Oh, I think I'm still mad enough. Oh, yeah.
You haven't improved a bit. You're still an amateur.
And you're still a fucking bitch.
Thanks. And I cook, too.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Christ.
Nothing I can't handle. Is Lydia watching?
Yeah, she's watching. What'd you have in mind? Huh?
I want you to fuck me right here. Right now.
God. I love it when you're bad.
Let's give her something to really see.
Thank you.
How'd you like growing up in Long Beach?
Long Beach?
You said you went to school there?
Yeah, I grew up there.
How'd you like the sorority initiation?
I didn't. Hey, I guess we sort of ruined your weekend, huh? Let me help you.
Steaks are okay.
Steak's fine.
Barry, I want these people out of my house.
What happened to the sorority sister thing? I mean, I thought you guys were bonding for life.
Who the hell are these people?
Okay, you want them to go? I'll tell them to leave.
Wait, you really would?
Of course I would. I mean, I've been talking to Cal about business, though.
You thinking about going into business with him?
I don't know. Maybe. Look, if you want, I'll talk to him next week. It doesn't make any difference
to
me.
No.
What? What do you...
It's okay. I mean, business is business. You're right.
Good. Good. Then you'll try and get along with him? Who knows what you could learn from him?
Who knows what I could catch from him?
Can't stand Barry.
What? He too kinky for you?
I think something else is going on.
I worry your pretty little head about it.
Kiss my ass.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Delicious steak, Barry. I love a nice, juicy piece of meat.
Good.
Barry says you're into horse racing.
Yes, I am. Sure is a nice place you got here.
Yes, well, fortunately, my wife does know how to run a business.
You two work together?
Well, we're pretty much of a team.
Barry and I did once. It was great.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean. Something just sort of happens. After a while, you drift apart.
Why is that?
Boredom.
Monotony.
Monogamy.
Start off competing against each other. And when one of you wins, the other one loses. So you take it to another level. Personal level.
Well, at least you two are still together.
Yes, we are still together.
together or tethered?
Tethered. Now there's a word I like. I guess she didn't want to play.
Doesn't mean we can't continue. Art.
Yes, it does. You're paying us to spice up your married sex life, Barry. Come on, Cal. I'm bored stiff.
Yeah.
know you do. Say it. Say you like it. Say it! Say it! Say it! Say it!
Yes!
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 Yes, let me hear it!
Like, a lot.
What's all this?
An apology.
Oh, really? For what? Sleeping with my husband?
Cal and I left right after you did. The way you've been talking, I just thought you might want a little spice in your marriage. I thought it would give you a jump start.
But you thought wrong.
I'm sorry.
It's not physical with me. It's a mental thing, you know? I mean, I accept the fact that I'm conservative. What I don't get is why that's wrong.
Well, when it comes to sex, I say nothing is wrong.
If it were only that easy.
Hey, talk to me. You'll probably never see me again.
Barry, he really scares me sometimes.
Good scare or bad scare?
Bad scare.
So leave.
Couldn't do that. We've been together too long. That would really be like losing.
You don't lose very often, do you, Lydia?
No, I.
The divorce would be like losing a big business deal?
Hey, marriage is a business deal, whether we admit it or not. You have sex with me tonight, I'll watch the kids for you tomorrow. You know how it goes.
You say so.
I guess I put my business before my marriage one too many times. I'm paying for it now.
So change it around. Get crazy. Let loose.
I'm not good at loose.
Do you want to be?
Not as loose as you.
Honey, no one's as loose as me.
Look, I know what I promised. It's just some of this I can't control. No, I can't exactly tell you that. No, I can't get away, not even for an hour. Look, you gotta understand this. I'm dealing with a very smart lady. And by the way, before I forget about it, I don't want to stay in that flea bag of a hotel anymore. It stinks. And look, I gotta go, right? I'll call you in a day or so, all depending on what goes on here. Maybe we can get away for a few days, or... Yeah, me too. How long have you been standing there?
You lying piece of shit.
Oh, I guess you've been standing there long enough. You want some of this, Gwen?
Get the fuck away from me. See, you cheat on her, too. You just can't be faithful to anyone, can you?
Oh, that's so perceptive, Gwen. Actually, it was a lot easier to be faithful to Lydia because she had money and class. It's pretty.
I think you like that too much.
I think you're right.
Bought a racehorse for Christmas once.
Quite a stocking stuffer.
Not really. Barry got so involved, he lost focus in his business. Lost focus in almost everything, I guess. What happened to you?
What's it look like? I cut my hand. I'm gonna go to the house and get something for it, all right?
I wanna leave now.
No way. Not before we collect our 10 grand.
I hate that guy.
Look, I'm sorry, babe, but he's paying us good money for services rendered.
Cal, he's crazy.
Is that why you stabbed his hand, huh?
No, I did that for my own personal pleasure. He's got a girlfriend.
So?
If he has a girlfriend, why does he need us to liven up his marriage?
I don't know. It's none of our business. Just stay out of it, okay? Okay?
Barry, what the hell's going on? Get this out of my house. Barry, I thought we agreed there'd be no guns.
I know that we agreed that. We were just gonna be isolated this weekend, so I...
We wouldn't be so isolated if you hadn't cut the phone cords, would we? Fix your cut.
You were prom queen, quill and scroll, cheerleader, and chess champion. Was there anything you didn't do?
Yeah, marry the right guy.
You don't think you can work things out, huh?
Frankly, no.
What's missing? Excitement? Lust?
Why is it you think sex is the answer to all your personal problems?
I don't know. It just seems like a fun way to work things out.
But if you go beyond the sex, you have to look at yourself, judge yourself, find out who and what you really are.
I'm too young to look at myself. I just want to have fun.
Someday it'll be important to you.
Are you sure you don't want to try to work things out? Divorce is a messy thing. I've done it twice.
It's time to face facts and get on with my life.
Sorry.
Yeah, me too. I gotta go do something.
Can I help? You're not really my sorority sister, are you?
Why do you ask?
Well, no offense, but it's painfully obvious. So how about being honest with me? Get to the truth, shall we?
Barry hired us. He wanted us to be incredibly sexual, to arouse you, to turn you on to the kinkier things in life.
I see.
Well, at first I thought it was a great idea. A completely sexual weekend. I mean, what could be greater than that?
Well, after tonight, we won't have to see each other anymore. Go our separate ways. I hope he paid you well.
Could be better. Much better.
Well, if you'll recall, we never offered you any guarantees.
I know that.
So, when do we pick up the cash for this little gig?
Don't worry, you'll get your money. Later tonight.
sometimes you find your destiny, and sometimes your destiny finds you.
Gwen and I, we like adventure.
What kind of adventure?
Something exotic, personal.
Much more personal.
Into.
Like what?
Just how daring are you, Lydia?
Not very, I'm afraid.
Come on. You're straight-laced on the outside, but there's a part of you you try very hard to hide.
I want you to hear what they're saying.
You hide the part that's dirty. Part that's not so nice. Part that's not socially acceptable.
What are you getting at?
Last night, when we were in the jacuzzi, we knew that you were watching us. And we knew what you were doing when you were watching.
Barry, let's go.
No. But you come out because of fear.
Barry. No. You like watching, don't you, Lydia? It's okay. Everybody likes to watch. Don't tell me you've never fantasized about being with another man when you were making love to Barry.
I need to do something completely different. Something wild.
Something to shake you up.
Shake us all.
Did you ever hold a gun to someone's head while they were having sex, Lydia? Of course not. Come on, try it. It's not loaded. So hard and so cold. Come on, do it. Come on, yeah? Do it against my head. Hold it against my head. Against my head. Hold it against my head. Hold the trigger, okay?
I can't.
Yes, you can. Do it, Lydia. Do it now. Do it.
I can't.
Yes, you can. Do it now. Do it.
Do it. After.
What for? We can't make her like sex.
I said go get her. I'm paying you $10,000 for these little lessons, so go get her.
No.
Look, the sorority pin gave us a base of trust to work from, but the game's over. It's time to pay up.
She's just not into swinging. There's nothing we can do to change that.
You can only push her so far.
It was 6 feet under. Too far. You haven't done a fucking thing. She's still a frigid bitch.
Hey, we tried.
Well, you didn't try hard enough. You're fired.
What are you gonna do?
kill us for not getting your wife interested in kinky sex? Perhaps.
He didn't care if he succeeded or not. You don't want to work things out with your wife, do you, Barry? You hate her so much you wish she was dead.
That's brilliant, Gwen. Brilliant. Do you see, officer, I was spending a weekend alone with my wife until these vicious criminals came along. And they took her and they tied her up. And they beat her and had sex with her. And then they blew her brains out. Thank you so very much.
Why are Cal and Gwen here?
Does it matter?
It matters to me.
All right. They are going to be set up to take the blame for your untimely death.
Why, Barry?
Why, Lydia? Because I don't want to take the blame. Oh, forgive me. You want to know why I want you dead? Number one, you are an uptight pain in the fucking ass. Number two, I got a mistress. And number three, I want your money. So let's see. What's the coroner gonna say when he finds sperm in the body, huh? They'd say, well, at least she went out happy.
Fuck you!
Nothing.
You're gonna die now, Lydia.
How much do I owe you?
Guilty now, who paid the cost to reach?